Hi, and welcome to this finance lecture for Stockholm Business School. I will talk about time value of money, and more specifically, the present value of a growing annuity. My name is Anders. As usual, we start with some repetition. And we said that financial decisions was about giving up resources today in the hope of obtaining something good in the future. And in order to compare the initial outlay, or what we give up today, with what we get in the future, we need to have the concept time value of money, where we assume that money today is better than money in the future. Due to inflation, interest rate and uncertainty, I can buy more stuff for the same amount of money today compared to in 2 years' time, for example. I can deposit the money today on a bank account and get interest. And last of all, there is always some uncertainty. If I get the money today, I know that I have the money. If I get the money in the future, it might be very likely that you get the money, but it's not completely certain. So, to do this, we had some formulas. We had the future value and then present value. The future value takes one cash flow today, see here, and you multiply it with 1 plus the interest raised to the power of n, where n is the amount of years you want to move it, and you get the equivalent future cash flow, or the equivalent future value. So getting C today is equal good as getting this whole here, C plus times 1 plus the interest rate raised to the power of n in n years. And we said that we can do the reverse as well. We could calculate the present value of some cash flow C that we get in n years by dividing it with 1 plus the interest rate raised to the power of n. So getting the present value here, or this whole thing today, is equally good as getting C in n years. So we can perhaps move on, and we said that the net present value was the present value of the positive cash flow minus the present value of the negative cash flows. So basically present value of all cash flows. And once again, it's called the net present value because it's the net of the present values. Last time we talked about the present value of an annuity, and we said that a series of equally big cash flows are called an annuity, and we can calculate the present value of this annuity by taking the cash flow, or one of the cash flows, divide by the discount rate, multiply with the whole factor here of 1 minus 1 divided by 1 plus r, r once again the discount rate, raised to the power of n, which is the amount of cash flows in the annuity. If we have an annuity of 5 equally big cash flows, then n is 5. And a shorter version, or as you would see it in the formula sheet, is just like this, where PV is short for present value. Now, however, we will expand our model a bit, and we will talk about the present value of a growing annuity. So now we allow us to compute the present value of a growing annuity with a single formula. So what is a growing annuity? Well, instead of having equally big cash flows, we have equal growth between any two cash flows. I will show you in a bit. And that is the requirement that the growth between any two consecutive cash flows need to equate. So the growth between the first and the second cash flows need to be equally big as the growth between the third and fourth cash flow, for example. And once again, just as before, it has to be equally long between every cash flow. So this might be, for example, a growing annuity. If we take the last example, but we allow the cash flow to grow. So the first cash flow is 80 once again, but now we allow for, this is actually a 5% growth between every cash flow. So the second cash flow is 80 times 1 plus the growth. And since it's 1 year from here to here, it's raised to the power of 1. So you will see if you take 80 times 1 plus 5% raised to the power of 1, you will get 84. And we can also take this one here, for example. You can then take 80 times 1 plus the growth, which is 5%. And it's 1, 2, 3 years. Raised to the power of 3. And you will get 92.61. So, if it is an equal growth or equally big growth between any two consecutive cash flows, and if the cash flow has exactly one period between themselves, so if it's 1 year between the first and the second cash flow, it needs to be 1 year between the second and the third cash flow, and so on. And if it's 5% growth between the first and the second cash flow, it needs to be 5% growth between the second and the third cash flow, and so on. And we will now have a formula that can, just as the present value of an annuity, we can calculate the present value of all these cash flows using one formula. So we say that the present value of a growing annuity, with this formula, we move every future cash flow to a single value 1 period before the first cash flow. So just as the present value of an annuity, as in the previous lecture. The formula looks like this. To get the present value of this growing annuity, you take the first cash flow. Now it's very important that it is the first cash flow. I write it down. So in our previous example, this is 80. So you should not take like the third cash flow or whatever. Take the first cash flow. You divide this by the interest rate or the discount rate minus the growth. And you then take and multiply this with the factor 1 minus. Here you have 1 plus the growth. And you divide it by 1 plus the discount rate. And both these, or this whole thing, should be raised to the power of n, which once again is the amount of cash flows in the growing annuity. It looks a bit messy here. So, and this is how it looks in short version. What is very, very important is when you calculate it, you don't forget any brackets. So it's very important to have brackets here. And also it's important to have brackets here and here. It's just to remember. And it's mostly better to have too many brackets than too few. Of course, this can be written a bit more efficient, and you might need fewer brackets, But if you type it in like this, it's important to don't forget the brackets. So if we go back to our previous example, where we had an initial outlay of 300, and we, after 1 year, obtained 80, and then we had a 5% growth between every consecutive cash flow. And okay, here I have said 10%. In the picture before it was 5%, but it doesn't matter, we can have 10%. And the cost of capital is just as before, 15%. And we have 5 cash flows. So we use the formula here, and we take the first cash flow, which is 80, divide by, don't forget the brackets, the interest rate, 15%, minus the growth, 10%. We multiply this with 1 minus 1 plus the growth, 10%, divided by 1 plus the interest rate, 15%. And we had 5 cash flows. Sorry, it don't look that very good, but hope you can see. So if we calculate this, we get, well, approximately 319. So in order to get the net present value, we take the present value of the positive cash flows, which is 319, minus present value of the negative cash flows, which is the initial outlay. So we take net present value equals to 319 minus 300, which is 19. So now, if this investment allows for a 5% growth between every cash flow, it is a good investment. It would increase the value of our company. How the investments change the value of the company, Johan will talk more about later. I will not go into detail about that, but we can conclude that a present value or a net present value of 19 is good, since it's above zero. So the net present value of this investment opportunity is 19. So if we should do another example, we can go back to the teaching assistant as in the last lecture. So the teaching assistant have now heard that the student grants will increase 10% annually. This information makes her believe that she will be able to sell solutions for 10,000 the first year, as before, but then have a positive sales growth of 7% annually for the coming 20 years. Assume that the initial outlay and cost of capital is the same as before. So we can, as usual, start with typing down what we already know, and we can, of course, calculate the present value of the cash flows she will gain if she makes these solutions for the exams. So the first cash flow was 10,000, so we can take 10. Sorry, I'm just gonna switch color. So the first cash flow was 10. I denote 1,000 with a prim. And we should divide by the interest rate, which was 10%, minus the growth, like that. And then multiply with the factor 1 minus 1 plus the growth. Divided by 1 plus the interest rate, which was 10%. And we should raise this to the power of 20, since it was 20 payments. We can now calculate this, and then we get 141,599. So the net present value of these solutions would be the present value of the positive cash flows, which is 141,599, minus present value of the outlay, which is 100,000. And we get 41,599. So if the teaching assistant indeed makes these solutions, she will get a present value, a net present value salary of 41,599. So making the solutions will give her 41,599 more than the other work she can do. So we would thus recommend her to make the solutions and sell them. So to summarize, the present value of a growing annuity is calculated as follows. So to get the present value, we take the first cash flow, we divide with the interest rate minus the growth, and then we multiply this with the whole factor 1 minus 1 plus the growth divided by 1 plus the interest rate, and we raise this to the power of n, which is the amount of cash flows. And once again, don't forget the brackets. You should also remember that the growth between every two consecutive cash flow needs to equate. So it needs to be the same growth between the first and the second, and between the second and the third, and so on. And it has to be equal along between every cash flow. And once again, the value received is in one period before the first cash flow. And that was all for today. Thank you very much.